Microsoft Windows is currently the most widely used operating system in the world, with over a billion personal computers and mobile devices running various versions of it across the globe. And there have been over 70 versions of Windows released since 1985, some of them more popular than others. If you've been using Windows on your PC in the past 10 years, you may have been, or still may be using, Windows version 7. It's important to know which version of Windows your PC runs on because of the Microsoft product lifecycle. That's a fancy way of saying that every 10 years, Microsoft and other software providers phase out old versions of their software to make way for new ones that are based on the latest technology. When a software or operating system reaches the end of its life cycle, it's said to be at the end of its life, which means that the manufacturer is no longer going to be sending out updates for it, which include important updates and patches that normally fix security vulnerabilities and help keep your computer safe. Microsoft has announced that all support for Windows 7 will end on January 14th, 2020. Your IT provider should be able to let you know what version of Windows you're running based on information they use to monitor your systems, but you can also check for yourself. You may have a sticker on your PC tower or laptop which tells you which operating system the computer came with, but it's possible that you've had an upgrade since then, so it's important to check the software version of the operating system itself. To do so, select the Start button, right-click on Computer, and then select Properties. Under Windows Edition, you'll see the version and edition of Windows that your system is running. If you don't see Computer listed under the Start menu, or right-clicking does not provide a Properties option, you may not be using Windows 7. Newer versions of Windows, like 8.1 or 10, can be found by pressing the Start button, then typing in WinVer, W-I-N-V-E-R, and clicking OK. A Windows version box should then pop up, displaying which of the later versions of Windows your system is running. In March of 2019, Microsoft began displaying notifications on Windows 7 computers about the upcoming end of support using a pop-up message which directs users to purchase the Windows 10 operating system or to purchase a new system altogether. If you are running Windows 7, you may want to know if you can upgrade your computer to Windows 10, or if you will need to buy a new computer altogether. There are several aspects of your computer hardware that would need to be looked at to determine if it was compatible with Windows 10, or if it had the capability to become compatible if you decided to upgrade some of its components, like its hard drive, memory, or CPU. However, rather than make everyone examine all of these components, we've gathered data from our technicians and sales engineers after analyzing hundreds of computers and created an easy rule of thumb to follow instead. If your computer was purchased before the year 2016, it probably will not be able to or be cost-effective for you to try to upgrade that old hardware to Windows 10. So in that case, you'll want to look into buying a new computer, which will likely come with Windows 10 already installed. But if your computer was purchased in 2016 or later, it may either already be able to support Windows 10, or it may only require a few component upgrades to support Windows 10 instead of having to buy a whole new machine. If you're still unsure, contact your IT provider and they can help you look at those components and find out which option is best for you, upgrading or buying a whole new machine. If you're already a client of 1-to-1, be on the lookout for special hardware promotions coming soon to your inbox to help make the transition to Windows 10 less expensive for your whole business. Since the end of an operating system's life means the end of support for updates and patches for it, running Windows 7 after January 14th, 2020 could be very dangerous for your business. If you watched our video on malware, you know that some malware is written to exploit specific security flaws that new updates and patches are there to fix. No updates means no fixes, so you would be far more likely to be infected with malware using a Windows 7 computer. And, depending on the type of business you work for, running Windows 7 with no support could mean that you are no longer compliant with regulations meant to protect government or medical data like NIST or HIPAA, and that could endanger the security of your company's data as well as the public. Windows 7 end of life is January 14th, 2020. So you'll want to order your upgrades or new computers soon to make sure they're in place before that deadline. Existing 1-to-1 clients can contact our client relations team, and we'll help you plan out the best way to upgrade your systems and keep you protected. If you're not yet a client of 1-to-1, now's a perfect time to reach out. Let us know about your needs, and we'll help you prepare your business for this and any other change you might be facing. Visit our website for more information about one-to-one or give us a call anytime. Protecting and growing businesses using technology is what we do. Let us make sure you're ready for the Windows 7 end of life. Thanks for watching.